how are you doing, Cinema Satsang viewers? Good evening. Today we are going to talk about Annayum Rasoolum or Annayum Rasoolum. Anna and Rasool, let's just put it that way. Annayum Rasoolum is a very romantic film. And mind you, I'm not talking about a very conventional Hindi film, a romantic film. But it is so beautiful, it is so heartwarming. And the simplicity, the beauty lies in its simplicity. Directed by Rajeev Ravi, a great cinematographer, an FTI pass out, and the cinematographer of Vasipur, Gangs of Vasipur. Yes, Rajeev Ravi's directorial debut. And he is a master of taking candid shots, or shots which look like candid shots, on the roads, on the streets, on the boats. You know, he is a master of capturing reality in a very, very, very beautiful manner. That's Rajeev Ravi for you. The setup takes a little long time to establish the location, the character. Rajeev Ravi takes his time, but once the love story kicks in between Anna and Rasool, then you are just mesmerized. See, this is a director's film. The story is simple. It's a Rasool, a cab driver in Kochi, and Anna, who is from Vaipin, but she goes to work in Kochi, and then there's this ferry ride which she has to take every day. And then once the love story kicks in, he starts to follow her in the ferry every day. Well, I'm coming to that. So Rasool is a modest cab driver and Anna is a modest sales girl in a big retail shop. And of course, she's a Christian and he's a Muslim. So the story is, you know, it's a normal story. And in fact, I just saw one Rajeev Ravi interview, just a little bit. He spoke about Annayum Rasoolum and he said it's based on Romeo and Juliet. So we all know what Romeo and Juliet is. But when you watch the film, you don't realize that, because the interpretation which he has given to this film, the cinematic treatment, the beautiful treatment, the moods which he has created in this film is beautiful. They are of modest, humble beginnings, and Rasool's family and Anna's family, both the families have a lot of problems. And one day, while running or chasing or helping his gangster friends, he looks at Anna and it's almost like love at first sight. And then there's no looking back, and he follows her in the ferry every day. And then the beautiful courtship starts, which I'm going to tell you about. And the subplots, there is Rasool's brother who's trying to get a visa and he's not getting one. And there is a narrator, a sutradhar, who comes to Kochi and in the beginning of the film, and he drives with Rasool. A small scene, I'll tell you. He tries to smoke in the car and Rasool tells him, don't. So then when Rasool asks him, you have been to so many places, you're a sailor, so tell me, where are the most beautiful girls? And he says, over here in Vaipin. So then Rasool allows him to smoke in the car. And then, of course, there are these two fighting factions. They are Rasool's friends. Sobin Sahir is there in a very small part. And in the other side, Anna's brother, Shane Ningham, a very, very, very small part. It's so beautiful. In Kumbhalangi Nights recently, Fahad didn't have a very big role. He had a major role, but Shane Ningham was the hero in that. So this is the setup. This is the story. Now the courtship period, which is the best part, and you can see this again and again and again. First, the look of the character Anna. This is played by Andrea Jeremiah, and I have seen some of her other pictures. She looks very glamorous in many of them, and in this, it is such a different avatar and a very simple ethereal look, and in a sari and a strand of hair always coming out and, you know, falling on her cheeks. So yeah, after he spots her and he starts following her in the ferry, So they look at each other, looking at each other motif. They don't talk to each other. They just look at each other. The way she looks at him, the way he looks at her. And Fahad Fazil is also brilliant as a shy cab driver, but he becomes slightly fearless in love, and he follows her in the ferry, and finally he tells her, okay, I like you. And after that, the love story picks up and the slow motion comes for the first time, and Rajeev Ravi has captured these locations beautifully, these real locations, and this is aided by some wonderful background score and wonderful songs, I must say. The music composer is called K, and he's a young chap in his 30s, and he's done a fabulous job. Once the love story starts to kick in, the theme music comes, and it starts with a mouth organ, and then the songs. One is a courtship song of the boy. But then suddenly I came across, this is a very old Malayalam song, and Rajeev Ravi has taken it in his film. And this praises the beauty in a very simple way, the beauty of a girl. If you think of a Hindi song, Ek Ladki Ko Dekha To Aisa Laga, from 1942, A Love Story. So yes, this song is in her praise and her beauty. And then when she gets smitten by him, there's another song, it's a romantic lullaby, and it is sung by Andrea Jermia herself. Oh, what a bundle of talent, I must say. Kandu, kandu, kina vilindurali, karilindullil. So it's a beautiful song, and at that point she applies bindi and she waits for him. And so finally, you know, when they have this, she calls her somewhere and they have a confrontation. She tells him that it won't work out, and they are in a rickshaw together, and he says, so what is my fault if I'm a Muslim, the regular stuff. And then one day she takes him to the church to take her approval of her sister. And who is her sister? And she asks him about conversion and stuff, and he said, no, there's no need, I'm not going to convert, and she's not going to convert. Rajeev Ravi has touched upon this conversion issue in the end of the film, and of course we have also done a show called Love Jihad it's a new show on our channel, News Flu. Okay, that's a satire. So she takes him to the church, but why I'm telling you this is nothing to do with because of these issues, but they go in the bus, okay, she, he is standing and she is sitting in the bus, okay. And then as he comes to sit beside her, the seat gets empty, someone else comes and sits. So that's the thing. Then he comes, why I'm telling you this, I'm coming to that. And then he comes and sits behind her, and it is such a heartwarming, moment, and with the background score, and the heat, he puts his hand on the railing and her hair is flying in the wind, and the hair is touching his hand, and this is the first time she has opened her hair. It's small things, very mundane, I don't know how to put it. And then the camera angle, which is the best part. And maybe that's why I'm doing film appreciation of this film. This angle with the hair flying in the air, you know, and she's there and he's behind her. It is just brilliant camera work. As an aside, I would say classically, big cinematographers who specialized in cinematography, from film school, They did not make very good directors, but these days everything is changing and this multitasking. Of course, there are exceptions. These camera cinematographers who turn directors will kill me. But Rajeev Ravi is just... So he should do a masterclass in cinematography, how to switch between a cameraman and a director. Because as I told you, he has shot many of Anurag Kashyap's films as well. And he has made gangster films. I have not seen that gangster film, but I hear it very, it's very good. And coincidentally, I did a song review of his another film. I have not seen the film, Najan Steve Lopez. But I just did a song review of that film on my channel. So coming back to that, and this framing, this shot, and also I would like to tell you, when she comes out of the church, when she comes out of the church, there are flowers in that lane, and Anna is wearing a floral dress. Was it a coincidence, or was it a design? Was it so? And also, the best, the beauty of this film are the seasons. Rajeev Ravi has also shown the seasons in this film. And of course, the rainy season is very romantic. So when the romance kicks in, the rains also kicks in. And the mise-en-scene of the rooms in which Fahad Fazil lives, Rasool lives, the simple curtains in Anna's room, in the Sutradhar's room, the narrator's room, Fahad's friend, where is the neighbor of Anna, and he goes there to, you know, look at Anna. So, and the lighting conditions change with every season, with every mood. In one of the shots, in a romantic shot, the light is falling on Anna. A simple shot, you know, simple beside the window shot. But it's not flat. It creates a mood. It evokes a mood. This film evokes a mood. That is good cinema. You know, it creates something in you. It stirs you up. It is not just drama, but the mood which it creates. And sometimes the mood is better than the actual thing itself. After the courtship, the beautiful period is over. Then there are fights between the gangs, and then he beats up her brother. She gets angry, and then finally the meeting is set up between them. You know, and then all hell breaks loose. Her brother beats him up, and they are separated. And he goes to work somewhere else, where a person tells him that, see, if you miss her, you go underwater, and you open your eyes, you'll see her. This thing, this is of relevance towards the end of the film as well. And then she is getting married off, and then finally he musters up the courage, and he goes and takes her. He elopes with her. Then this final beautiful song comes, Vari Vakil, sung by Shweta Mohan, I think. Vari Vakil, Veya Kalya, Marami. And then the ending is very tragic. When I, someday if I meet Rajeev Ravi, I'm going to ask, okay, I know it's based on Romeo and Juliet, but you know, it's so harsh, a very harsh ending. Very tragic ending. You never want to reach at that point to see that ending. And then and Rasool, finally he goes, and in, of course, we see Dockyard Road, so he's in Bombay and he's diving underwater, and so it's not very clear what he does. He's wearing those sea diving glasses, so maybe he's a sea diver, I don't know. Another Malayalam film I saw which had a bizarre end was Trance. You know, these two characters, they land up in Amsterdam, and in a red light area, the girl lands up. So I don't know, but yeah, the ending is very tragic. Love stories have a looking at each other motif, especially very ethereal, very subtle. Very beautiful love stories have looking at each other motif. You know, a man and a woman. What a wonderful, beautiful, romantic film. Made in the 60s, Oscar winner. It had a lot of looking at each other, especially I think when they are driving. So they look at each other, and I also made a romantic film, End of Love, a tragic romantic film, End of Love. And it also had a lot of looking at each other's shots. There were no dialogues in the film, a 30-minute film. I would say that was also a very romantic film. The girl coming out of VT station in a hat and in boots. Of course, it was Bombay winter, but and the guy comes and picks him up on a motorbike, picks her up on a motorbike, and they go to a ferry near the Taj, near the gateway, and spend a beautiful day there. So, and with a sweeping background score, clarinet based. So yeah, if I would have seen a man and a woman earlier, maybe I would not have made this film. So looking at each other, motif in Annayum Rasoolum, in Man and a Woman, in End of Love. So, and maybe you'll find it in many other love stories as well. A Hindi romantic film, not looking at each other, motif, I would say was a very romantic film, Chandni, Yash Chopra's Chandni. Sadly, the all the protagonists are no longer with us currently. So I was telling you about the songs. Now I'll tell you briefly about some one or two lyrics I'll read out to you. But also there is a wonderful song in the end, a very painful rendition of yearning, a very Sufi song. A very Sufi song, and in a very soulful voice. Of course, I'm not talking about Atif Aslam kind of song. I have nothing against Atif Aslam. He's a lovely singer. But, you know, it's very soul-searching. Now, I'll read out the lyrics of a couple of lines. From some of the songs, not that song. Flowing forever, grief-stricken in search of shores. Flowing forever, grief-stricken in search of shores. Within my innermost self, you became the seven seas. Where's your oar as you journey into the ocean? Where's your oar as you journey into the ocean? Sufi told us about the wonders of love. Never did they warn that it also meant death. I'll tell you about God. You know, God normally separates people, in especially in films. Religion, not God, religion. But over here, God helps them unite, because she goes to church and she sings these hymns, and these lyrics maybe inspire her to take the final fearless step. Some of the lyrics are: a realization that love is to endure. I witness that to love is to accept death. O divine mercy of love. Love is an extension of the divine. Now comparisons with Sairat. Sairat is also a director's film, fantastic film, about caste, how caste divides people. So Nagaraj Manjule basically wanted to give this message strongly, but he made his earlier films, but no, he said no one watched that. But now he wanted people to come to the theaters to watch his magnum opus Sairat with songs, and he did recording in the in Hollywood and with big orchestra, and of course the music by Achi Atul, it was fantastic. So this was also a love story. The first half was a love story and the second half became grim, and then finally the tragic ending. So there are some similarities between, of course you can't blame him, because it's anyone can adapt Romeo and Juliet. So there is this song, once the boy is smitten, there is a from the boy's side one song, Kandarinda, and then in Sairat also, and then from the girl's side there is one song. So these are some of, but the striking similarity is in the ending. In Annayum Rasoolum, the sound is muted for a very short time. In Sairat, this has been extended. The sound is almost muted for 1 or maybe 2 minutes, a very long time. But this whole silencing in the end is there. two directors can think alike? Maybe. Maybe yes. And in Sairat, though, the public was saying, "Arey, sound chalu karo, sound chalu karo." Oh, anyway, I'm digressing. So yeah, these are the some of the comparisons. And of course, there are these road shots and traveling shots, and the characters are moving on the roads. All these things are also there. But completely different films. Two snippets, when he sends her messages on phone. Oh, yes, Sairat mein phone ka use bhi bahut hai. So when he sends messages to her on phone, he writes, of course, phone is unavoidable these days, cheat dreams. Instead of sweet dreams, he writes cheat dreams, C-H-E-E-T, cheat dreams. Another small snippet, the smile of a co-worker, just one shot, beautiful smile. And Rajeev Ravi has used that moment. And very important thing, it's on Amazon, but there are no subtitles, which is ridiculous. Ridiculous. So currently it's streaming on MUBI. MUBI is a very fantastic platform. I haven't seen Netflix in 6 months. But MUBI is a fantastic platform for world cinema, Indian cinema, for film lovers. So anyways, it's streaming on MUBI and there are no subtitles on Amazon currently. Watch this beautiful romantic film in the Valentine month of February. And this is a cinema satsang recommendation. It's an appreciation of a film in our film appreciation section. And it's not just for Malayalam viewers. Malayalam viewers may have already seen this film, but I'm very grateful and appreciative of them that they are giving us our channel so much of love. But this film is not just for Malayalam film viewers. This is for everyone. It is superbly shot, very well shot, and directed by Rajeev Ravi. As I told you earlier, it creates a mood. And this is one of the functions of cinema. You know, this is one of the, to evoke a mood. This is the power of cinema. So watch it for the masterful direction, the beautiful songs, the lyrics, and the lovely actors, the cast. Andrea Jermia and Fahad Fazil, he's a darling, you know. And of course, the girl also. But we need more love stories, maybe in India, from a woman's perspective. This is all a very man's perspective, and even Shakespeare was a man. So maybe we need more love stories from a woman's perspective. So yes, and please write in to us, comment on our section. We would love to hear what you think about love and what you thought about this film and maybe Rajeev Ravi's other films. And so Anurag Kashyap is a very smart director to hire Rajeev Ravi as cameraman for his films, I must say. And Rajeev Ravi is hats off switching between cameraman and director, and two very strong-headed directors working together. That's called a good collaboration, I must say. So yes, please write into us, comment on what you think about love and what is your definition of love. And if you have not fallen in love yet, if you're whatever your age is, you try it out. That's a good feeling. You should have that feeling sometime.